This strategy is the partial product strategy, which is a favorite of a lot of kids. The number of boxes you draw for this strategy depends on the size of the numbers you're multiplying. So for today, we're going to multiply 87 times 21. So we will draw a box that has four sections, one for each place value part of our numbers, 80 and 7, and 20 and 1. Then we'll multiply each number times the other number like a grid. 80 times 20 is 1,600. 80 times 1 is 80. 20 times 7 is 140. And 1 times 7 is 7. Once that's finished, you add all your numbers together, which gives you your final product of 1,827. The strategy I'm going to show you now is the lattice strategy. This strategy uses a box similar to the partial products box. So let's say we were going to multiply 23 times 15. You would draw your partial products box just like before. But this time when you put your numbers to the outside, you will not show them in place value. For example, you'll just put a 2 instead of a 20. Then in each box, you will put a diagonal line. The top of the diagonal line represents the tens. The bottom part represents the ones. For example, 2 times 1 is 2. 0 tens, 2 ones. 2 times 5 is 10. 1 10, 0 ones. 3 times 1 is 3. 0 tens, 3 ones, and 3 times 5 is 15. 1 10, 5 ones. At that point, each diagonal represents your different place value parts. This is the ones. This is the tens. This is the hundreds. And this would be the thousands if we had digits there. In our ones place, we have a 5. In our tens place, we have 3 plus 1, which is 4. And in our hundreds place, we have 2 plus 1, which is 3. The next strategy I'm going to show you is breaking apart one of the factors in a 2-digit by 2-digit number. Let's take 33 times 28. This may seem like an unmanageable problem for some, but if you take one of your factors, and for today we're going to take 28, and think about the easier ways that you could break it apart. For example, 33 times 10, because 10 is a very friendly number to multiply by, then we would have 18 left out of 28. Take another 33 times 10, and then we would have 8 left out of 28. And of course, you could break that apart however you wanted to. But let's just say, 33 times 4, and another 33 times 4. This works because we still, on this side, have 28 33s, which is what we were looking for in the first place. But it's just much easier for some children to break it apart and find friendly numbers to multiply by. This strategy is called halves and doubles, and in this strategy, you have two different factors. Let's say we have 45 times 24. And you decide which one of your factors can be halved, and then the other one is doubled when you break it apart. So let's say that we have 24 as our half one, because it's even, and 45 will be the one that we double. So 45 times 24 is the same as, if we have 24, we have 8, and we double 45, we have 90. Now this problem by itself is much easier for some children to do because you have a zero to work with. Any even tens are easier than numbers that don't have even tens. But you can half again. You can get this to 6, double this side to 180. You can even half again if you would like to, and get this side to 3, and this side to 360. Once you get to an odd number in your half size side, you are done with your halves and doubles, but it just allows children to change the problem and make an equivalent problem that might be easier for them to work with.